Would you be surprised to know that older adults are more often happier than younger people? Let's talk about mental health in later life. Older adults in the general population have about a 15 to 25% chance of having a serious mental illness compared to a 20% chance in the general population. Why does this statistic for older adults show much more variance? This is partly because older adults are more heterogeneous as a group. It also depends on whether or not the study included people in nursing homes. People in nursing homes make up only around 6 to 7% of the population, but 70 to 90% of that nursing home population have either a psychiatric condition and/or dementia, which is also considered a psychiatric condition. So part of the variance in the statistic is due to whether or not the survey of mental health included people in nursing homes, which would increase the number of those with mental illness or not. In general, if we were to look at data smoothed across developed countries like the US, UK, and Australia, your chance of having a diagnosable psychiatric condition decreases with increasing age. In this graph, you can see that population-based prevalence of mood disorders, anxiety disorders, and substance use disorders is lower than that of dementia in persons over age 65. However, with increasing age, your chance of getting dementia increases. This is why the overall lifetime chance of having a psychiatric illness is fairly constant at 20%. This graph is a simplified way of highlighting the increase in impact of dementia as a psychiatric illness later in life. But mood and anxiety disorders are also important to address, no matter when in life they occur. But the type of psychiatric illness one is more likely to experience also varies with where you are in the life course. Younger people are more likely to suffer from eating disorders, for example, and older adults are more likely to experience dementia. However, the majority of older adults, whatever setting they live in, are neither assessed nor treated for psychiatric disorders. Why is this? In an influential study, Helms and Gee presented psychologists with a vignette of a depressed patient. Only the age of the client was manipulated. The vignette described a white female patient, a Mrs. Watkins, describing symptoms to her psychologist, including tearfulness, loss of interest in activities, early morning awakening, and weight loss. The two versions of the vignette were identical, except for the age of the prospective female client, which was stated to be either 42 or 72 years of age. An initial question asked, "What is your first impression of what Mrs. Watkins' main presenting problem might be?" Participants were asked to diagnose the client, choose a therapeutic approach, and rate the appropriateness of the client for therapy. They were also asked to rate their own ability to develop a therapeutic relationship with the client, their own perceived competence in treating the client, and their ultimate willingness to accept the patient as their client. Both ages of client received a correct diagnosis of depression 90% of the time. However, compared to the younger client, the older client was described as having a poorer prognosis, as being less able to develop an adequate therapeutic relationship with the therapist, and ultimately as less appropriate for therapy. Finally, the therapist felt less competent and less willing to accept the older client. This is essentially ageism, a form of discrimination. Many old people faced ageist attitudes every day. There is much work to be done in building awareness of ageism in our culture, in much the same way as we are trying to change our cultures to reduce sexism and racism. This, of course, works both ways, as young and old people can be discriminated against. And whilst psychology is not the only profession vulnerable to ageism, it is a huge problem when ageist attitudes creep into clinical practice. Also, all health and mental health professions lack an adequate supply of new trainees to specialize in seeing older persons. This represents a major crisis in the healthcare arena globally.